Alright, so I've already looked at Jedi Academy, so I thought I would go back and look at its predecessor, which is Jedi Outcast. So it's pretty much the same type of game, although this one came out before, and if I'm reading it right, only a year before, which is kind of crazy. Although the engine is pretty similar and only a little refined in Jedi Academy, so I could easily see that being the case. But Jedi Outcast is a more linear style game, and by that I mean it is totally linear, in that you actually have a named character, which you see here, which is Kyle Katarn. And it's been a little while since I played this one. The controls are a little different. Can't exactly figure out how to pull up on my force powers. But this is pretty early on in the game. You played through a few missions because Kyle Katarn is a, I don't know if you want to say a bounty hunter, but he's like a mercenary at first. Like, he used to be a Jedi and he gave it up. But this is a point where your partner in crime has been captured by this dark Jedi. So you go to Luke and learn how to be a Jedi again, basically, and you get your lightsaber back. And so now this is jumping back into this story. I don't know if I can skip this stuff. Looks like I can't. There's actually more interesting story stuff going on here than in Jedi Academy. Like, the way these cutscenes are arranged, you don't get anything like this in Jedi Academy. But a lot of people like this game more, but I like Jedi Academy more just because, like, it is refined and there is... The whole created character thing is more interesting to me, but Kyle Katarn is a pretty popular character in the expanded universe, and Jedi Outcast is just as good as Jedi Academy. I just prefer Jedi Academy. And I wish I could skip this and get to the action, but this is the first mission where you get your lightsaber, so this is kind of the first time I'm going to be able to use it here. I have played through this game and beaten it, but like a long time ago, and I played it on GameCube, I think. It's out on a couple different platforms. This is the PC version on Steam, as the whole series is out on PC. It was released a while ago on Xbox and GameCube. This game came out in 2002. But yeah, an interesting thing to note about these games is they are on a modified Quake 3 engine. So I wonder, I never really played Quake, but I wonder if there are any Star Wars mods for Quake. I mean, it's kind of interesting because that's basically what this could be, a Star Wars mod. So as it is with Jedi Academy, the controls for the lightsaber are still kind of direction-based, like whichever way you're moving, you'll swing. So it can be kind of hard to hit some guys sometimes. But man, I love it. And you do get in less, or fewer, lightsaber battles, I should say, in this game, because in the whole story you can see in Jedi Academy, there's more reason for Jedi and Jedi battles. That's not something you really get in this game. Alright, so now, it is first and third person, just like Jedi Academy, so you can see I got my guns here. But I'm trying to figure out my powers. Here we go. So, I don't even remember what kind of powers you get in this game. I assume they're pretty similar, because, I mean, it's been so long since I've kind of dipped into the late game, but this is still, like, right when I become a Jedi again, so that's the biggest jump I got, and I only have some of the basic powers. Maybe I can push people. But I can still stick my lightsaber in the wall. So, yeah, they still got these things around where I can heal myself and get ammo. So you can see that just raised up my shield. So one thing about Jedi Outcast is this one is only slightly more puzzly, I would say. Whereas I find myself actually getting lost in this one more so than in the other game. So while the story may be linear, the levels are not as linear. So it does become a little confusing trying to figure out where to go. And you do have to explore like every corner of every level. Alright, so I just opened something. Let's hope it's this door. Nope. Definitely need some health packs here. I like just throwing the lightsaber. It's sometimes the best just like combat tactic. Alright, so I just basically did a big circle. Do I have like a speed power? Yes I do, so. Maybe that's. Oh wait, did I open the bar? Is that what I did? Yeah, so I can't activate the switch again. So maybe I just opened the bar. Yeah, okay. Oh, there's another switch. And help. See? Puzzle. Yeah, one thing I love about these Jedi Outcast and Jedi Academy games is just I feel like they're the only Star Wars games that get the feel of the lightsaber right. Alright, now that door's open. Oh, and I hear guys shooting at me. Whoa. Yeah, so I think this is a Nar Shaddaa, which is a planet that's pretty well known in the Star Wars expanded universe. Sometimes you just gotta bust out guns and get stuff done. I actually really like the sniper rifle, and it is a weapon that's helped me out of many problems in both of these games. Where sometimes you might be low on health and you just gotta hang back. Ooh, yeah, this level is full of snipers. That's one thing I do remember. Ooh, right in the head. Which I could use a little more tactics other than just standing there, but. Alright. Let's just stick with this thing for a little while. Alright, so. I need to find my way back in the bar. Oh, jeez. I need the upgraded jump. Ugh. I always like side flips. Any game lets me do a side flip. Alright, so. Maybe coming out here wasn't the best idea. Because now I feel kind of stuck. Oh, okay. That's the door I was looking for. So I think I need to get back up there. Yeah, the one thing about the sniper rifle guys is I don't think he even attempts to block their shots. Because you can't. Oh. I miss him at like point blank range. Great. Alright, so. I wonder if there's still health in there I can pick up. Oh, man. Well, that was embarrassing. Alright, well I can definitely load a later save, because I have those. So we don't have to play through that again. Just because I jumped off a ledge and died because I'm too busy talking and not paying attention to the guys I need to be lightsabering. Alright, so we get this nice swooping little shot again. But let's just load another one here. Load one a little later, see what we get. Alright, so, oh look, it's Lando Calrissian. Yeah, so like Jedi Academy, you will run into some other characters. I totally forgot about Lando in this one. God, I hate these guys who just throw grenades. Let's go, Lando. Oh, I forgot about the roll. You can actually do that in Jedi Academy too, and when you roll, you can like do a jab. Yeah, so this is Lando's ship we gotta get to. Alright, so. Found his ship.
How's it look?
Can't can't even move. Oh, didn't know I could do this. Got binoculars. Alright, so he's telling me I gotta find something. Okay, so he's probably opened one of these doors. Faced. And there you go. Way to go, dude. My powers here. I like push. It's kind of dark in here. I guess they don't really have the lighting effects down on this one where the lightsabers kind of light up a room. Pretty sure that happens in Jedi Academy. Just another reason why it's better, I guess. Huh. I guess it's still have to be in here. Use my lightsaber as my guide. No. Just hitting stuff. Alright, well, I don't want to fall down there, although it does look pretty cool. And it kind of looks like I'm just walking on air. There we go. Not seeing a puzzle. No flashlight. I can't duck into anything. Alright, well, I guess we'll go back the way we came, see what we can find. Direct entrance, we'll get nothing there. Well, it sounds like I can hurt this door. Nope. Let's try going back this way. Can't break any of the glass. Lando, you still got nothing for me? Okay, there we go. I just want to cut some dudes up. Somebody did shoot at me. Should have did a charge of shot. Alright. There's another guy with bombs over there. Man, you can fire this thing so much quicker when you're not zoomed in. Where's the fun of that? Ooh. Oh, he went flying. I don't know if you saw that. I always feel like I remember using a lot more guns on this one than Jedi Academy. Like, Jedi Academy, they give you enough stuff that you can do with your lightsaber that you never really need to pull out a gun. But I feel like in Outcast, I use a lot more guns. Especially because of, like, levels like this. Nope. Oh, that was a mistake. Looks like seal on the door. Okay, so I just unlocked that door, so that was pointless. And I think... Is that the elevator I came down in? I'm not 100% sure. Oh, here's a dude. Oh yeah, definitely doing circles here. Look, get it back. Well, I don't know if you can dismember in this one. In Jedi Academy, you can dismember. I guess this whole video is just going to be talking about what you can do in Jedi Academy that you can't do in this game. Which is a lot. Hit him. Yeah. Yeah, this shit ain't happening. Ooh, got him. At least we'll get some good shots here. Alright. Well, I just did a whole circle around this place and didn't see anywhere I could go, but I had people attacking me, so... And yeah, this is definitely the elevator I came down in. Yeah, I can walk. I don't want to be a badass. Let's just walk. There's a walkway up here, but this door is usually locked. Yeah, locked. Can't even jump on there. Definitely can't make that jump. Was there anything up there? No. Am I supposed to jump down to one of those lower levels? Secret stash over there. Ugh. Physics. Alright. I really feel like I should be able to do something with these, but I can't. Fire blindly. Okay. Oh, is that something? Well, I'm probably gonna die here, so... Yep. Alright, well, that's Jedi Outcast. It's definitely more the same, a little behind, but still just a great game, mostly for the story and the characters and stuff, so... I mean, if you're interested in Jedi Academy, you should be interested in Jedi Outcast 2, so... I mean, not Jedi Outcast 2, that's a different game. That's Jedi Academy, but Jedi Outcast also. But, thanks for watching. Got some more Star Wars videos coming up, so keep tuning in.